when Tamkine started, there were very few multifunctional shelters that didn't necessarily abide by the international norms and standards. Not even in Morocco did we have a clear idea. So an assessment was done, some shelters were established, and now through the program, we could see a lot more shelters that, first of all, abide by the rules, and also that empower all those women who are survivors with services that were not provided before. The percentages of violence against women in Morocco and girls aren't very different from many other countries worldwide, in the sense that it's mostly youth-related violence. It's young women who are mostly victims and survivors of violence, and it's young men overall who are the perpetrators of violence. But it's only when you meet the women who have been through hell, who are survivors of violence, who are outcasts, who had nowhere to go in the past, who didn't even have the law with them. And they find themselves in this haven where they can not only sleep and survive, but also learn new skills, find supporting community, find a voice, and find back a semblance of hope in life.
Her name is Raad. She was married. She has a son. She brought with her here to the center. She was married to a very violent man who practiced all kind of violence. It was very painful for her, so she decided finally to come to the center. Now she is feeling better. She's in the state of self-confidence, but we had to see her before coming to the center. The first day when she came here, she was in a very miserable state. Her name is Samia, and her problem is that her father didn't recognize her as his legal daughter. You cannot get your papers, your ID. You are not recognized as a citizen, so she had lots of problems. She went to see her father to ask him for to be recognized legally, but he refused. He just refused. She had lots of psychological problems. She tried to commit suicide twice. She swallowed a lot of pills to do so. And finally, she got here to the Bataha Center and asked for help. They helped her a lot with the moral support, with emotional support, and they also found her a job. And now she's very happy because she's overcoming her situation that was very complex.
The shelter center in Fez, the Bataha Center, was built by the state, by the Mohammed VI Foundation, very much like a lot of other centers in Morocco, but run by an NGO, MDGF. So what they're providing are services that range from sheltering women, what they call emergency sheltering, to helping them learn life skills such as catering, tailoring, jewelry making, and providing also services that are outsourced, such as ANAPEC services, which are provided by the states. They're like special, you know, services to help women who already have degrees or diplomas find jobs.
She benefited from bakery training, and she's ready to start working and be dependable, not depending on someone. When she first came here, she went to talk with the lawyer that gave her a lot of moral support. They helped her to find a job. Now she's happy because she can come here and spend time and talk to people and make friends and be spared from bad influence.
The main objective of the program is working on gender-based violence, you know, fighting against gender-based violence, of course, but through the empowerment of women and girls, through establishing the linkage with their poverty and vulnerability. So we have 4 outcomes and 9 outputs, dealing with different aspects related to the fight against gender-based violence, all the way from the reform of the penal law, the different, you know, projects and draft bills that are being pushed forward, the impact of the advocacy and communication of NGOs, especially women's rights NGOs, on this reform.
The first main help that she got from the Bataha Center is the legal help. They helped her to get divorced, they assigned a lawyer to her, and the most important thing that she learned that it's essential to not give up on her rights, to not succumb to the violence or to any bad conditions that women can encounter. She thinks that the state don't really protect her, because all those new laws for protecting women here in Morocco are mainly applied in NGOs. Because when she started to work in a bakery, he started to harass her. She went to the police to inform them about that. They didn't do anything for her. Once he kidnapped her kid, and she was like running to get her kid back, and she went to the police again, and they said like, well, he is his kid too, so we cannot charge him anything. The law, the protection of women are essentially in NGOs.
The key to breaking the cycle of violence against women is empowering them. And that's the philosophy of Tamkine as well. It's linking gender-based violence to the vulnerability and poverty of women.
She's spreading a message of hope. We women, we have to be all together, hand in hand, to fight this tragic phenomenon, which is gender-based violence. She is addressing as a message to all ladies in difficult situation in general is don't look back, just step forward. She's appealing those ladies to ask for help from specialized centers like Latha Center or NGOs. She asked them to not be afraid of asking.